We will start the press conference by Minister Motegi. The floor is yours. First of all, about my business trip overseas. If situations and circumstances permit, I plan to visit Africa, including Tunisia, Mozambique, South Africa, and Mauritius from next week. During this visit, through the collaboration towards the realization of free and open Indo-Pacific, and by reinforcing business relations with a view to post-COVID era, and by cooperation towards TICAD 8, I wish to powerfully promote a diplomacy with a sense of caring and robustness in Africa. You may be aware that in the case of Tunisia, it will be the host of TICAD 8. As for South Africa and Mozambique and Mauritius, these are very important for free and open Indo-Pacific, and they are on the eastern edge of this region. With regard to bilateral relationship with such countries, and as I just mentioned, in order to realize free and open Indo-Pacific, I look forward to a variety of discussions. The question, please. If you are invited to ask the question, please come forward to the microphone, tell us your name and affiliation, please.
NHK, Yamamoto-san.
Thank you. Yamamoto of NHK. I have two questions. First of all, about the Japan-U.K. EPA. In the committee of the upper house, it is expected to be approved. Looking back at the discussion at the Diet, your observations and your ambition going forward.
As I look back at the Diet deliberation this time, but I would say that the Japan-U.K. EPA, the negotiation was initiated on June the 9th, and in August, I made a physical visit to U.K., and together with Secretary for International Trade and Trust, for a whole 2 days, we had a face-to-face intense negotiation, and at that time, shared recognition on major points as of September 11, reached agreement in principle, and reached a signing on October 23. It has been submitted to the Diet, and as of today, in the upper house, I look forward to the agreement and adoption. Regarding this Japan-U.K. EPA, this is a clash of a national interest. It was extremely difficult and tough, but by avoiding the negative impact by Brexit, but in trying to achieve the highest level possible rules, and as a strategic global partner, by trying to take the leadership in international society's rulemaking by Japan and the U.K., we have managed to share our recognition between the two countries, and therefore, within an exceptional speed of four and a half months since the start of the negotiation, we have managed to reach agreement and signing. By this bilateral EPA, between post-Brexit U.K., even after the transition period, which means after the end of this year, the continuity of Japanese businesses will be maintained under a high level of discipline. I hope that the Japan-U.K. trade and investment will be promoted. In the case of Japan, we are trying to expand the free and open economic areas. We have taken international leadership in TPP-11, or this EPA, and U.S.-Japan trade agreement. This country, Japan, that we conclude the Japan-U.K. EPA, I think it is going to send out a very strong message to the global community that we are going to promote free trade, and this is highly significant.
Yes, please, the next question.
Another topic on Hong Kong situation. Apple Daily's founder, Jimmy Lai, Apple Daily has been critical of China and was prosecuted for fraud. The decision for confinement of Agnes Zhou has been issued as well. Please share your thoughts.
As far as Japan is concerned, our grave concern is increasing when it comes to the recent developments in Hong Kong, and this has been repeatedly, that is something that I have repeatedly said. The three decisions, including Agnes Zhou and Jimmy Lai, has been taken into custody. And Japan is seriously concerned about the impact on freedom of speech, press, and assembly, which serves as the basis for democratic and stable developments, which Hong Kong has enjoyed, and we are closely monitoring how this will evolve. Hong Kong is an extremely important partner for Japan, with which Japan maintains close economic ties and people-to-people exchange. It is the long-standing position of Japan to attach great importance to upholding a free and open system and a democratic and stable development of Hong Kong under the One Country, Two Systems framework. And Japan's concerns and our stance have been communicated upon the visit by Wang Yi, the State Councillor and the Foreign Minister of China, not only by me, but by Prime Minister Suga as well. And we have been communicating this to the Chinese side on different occasions. We will closely cooperate with other countries to respond appropriately.
Next question, Sugiyama-san, Japan Times. Sugiyama of Japan Times, a different topic. This is about the importance of face-to-face diplomacy. Because of COVID-19, face-to-face diplomacy had to stop. And as you mentioned, there were online discussions like the UK-Japan EPA, as you have mentioned, and you have joined online international conferences. Through these experiences, there might have been conveniences and inconveniences that you've experienced. What is your observation about online diplomacy? Compared to online, what is the importance of face-to-face physical meeting? In the case of this year, from January in China, COVID spread, and from March and onwards, in Italy and European countries, the pandemic spread. And in the first half of this year, my business travel, I went to Munich, and that was the end. And then after that, a G7 foreign ministers meeting was held online. Teleconferences were held, or telephone conferences were organized. I think more than 90 such discussions have been implemented. So where there is a physical distance, but the meeting itself is easy to organize online, but there is a time difference. But bilateral telephone conferences, in terms of scheduling, it was not too difficult. But time itself will be limited. You can't go on for 2 hours or 3 hours on the telephone, and therefore the agenda would be restricted and focused. As for the face-to-face physical meeting and diplomacy, in my case, I visited UK in August, so that was the resumption of my travel overseas. I directly met the top-level persons of the country speaking about bilateral relationships or about global challenges. So because I am there, I can spend quite a lot of time and talk in depth, and I have directly, palpably felt the importance of deepening understanding by a face-to-face meeting. By visiting your counterpart country, compared to TV conferences or telephone meetings with limited time, I can enter into in-depth discussions. I can also meet a top-level persons other than my direct counterparts in the government top levels. So in that sense, it is possible to intensify and extend bilateral relationship with confidence. In particular, the Japan-UK EPA, that is trade negotiation where national interest is at stake, or when it comes to sensitive diplomatic communication, rather than telephone or online, a face-to-face negotiation is necessary. In fact, as I just told you, in the case of Japan-UK EPA, within an exceptional speed of 4.5 months since the start, we have managed to sign the agreement. That is because I did make a physical visit to Britain. I had a bilateral meeting, including tete-a-tete, and together with Secretary Truss for International Trade. It is because I spent longer hours face-to-face with her, and throughout that process, our mutual confidence has been built. I think that was the important factor. On top of that, not only my business to travel overseas, but on the 6th of October, the Quad meeting was held. The Quad foreign ministers meeting was held, and just the other day,
Chinese counselor, Wang Yi, visited our country, and there was a foreign ministerial between Japan and China here in Tokyo. Across the global community, this kind of face-to-face meeting and different meetings to be hosted in Japan, I think Japan is ahead of other countries, according to my observation. Going forward, indeed, there are restrictions, but despite the restrictions, we want to continue our diplomatic effort, including face-to-face meeting.
Yes, please take the floor. Yesterday, lower house Q&A session of lower house special committee on Okinawa, and another problem had to be cancelled, and the opposition party organized a meeting for opposition, and this was cancelled due to the diplomatic schedule. What are your thoughts? The schedule of the diet should be determined by the schedule. Next, please.
Kato-san, Nikkei Shimbun newspaper. Kato, Nikkei Shimbun. There was an announcement about your visit to Africa. Mauritius, in July, a Japanese company-owned vessel caused an oil spill. And just the other day, a minister, you have spoken with the prime minister on the telephone and have communicated support. During this meeting, will you talk about this? With regard to Mauritius in the Indian Pacific, they are in a critical point geostrategically, and in order to realize a free and open Indo-Pacific, it is a very important maritime and democratic state. If I manage to visit, then because of the August oil spill incident, I mean, there are short-term supports by Japan, which is already implemented, but mid- and long-term cooperation situation, I will communicate what we can do, and I wish to confirm about collaboration in extensive areas.
Asahi Shimbun.
Sato-san, Asahi Shimbun. Sato, Asahi Shimbun. Today it was announced that you'll be traveling African countries, and on that issue, free and open Indo-Pacific, a direct visit by you, what implications and positive implications this could have on FOIP? You have visited European countries in Southeast Asia, and you have been touting realization of FOIP, and following on those visits, you will be visiting directly African countries under COVID-19. What is the significance of directly visiting these countries under COVID-19, and what is the significance in realizing FOIP? Your question was a bit complicated, so I do not understand your question. Other questions, please.
Hamamoto-san, Independent Web Journal. Good morning, Independent Web Journal. My question about the Hong Kong situation. There are three activists who have been handed down imprisonment, and Agnes Chow, before the sentencing, she was saying that she wanted to visit Japan, according to report. The government of Japan and the foreign ministry of Japan, due to the court decision this time, are you going to send out official statement of condemnation? And with regard to the three individuals, will there be any concrete actions for their release? Regarding the Hong Kong situation, and about the court decisions for the three individuals and their imprisonment, I have very carefully responded already to the earlier question.
Other questions, please. Nakata-san of Kyoto. Nakata. In Berlin, Germany, a statue of wartime conformed woman. Japan has been working to remove the statue, but there was a resolution in mid-war to keep the statue in place. So what are the steps that you will be taking in order to remove the statue? Mid-war decided to withdraw the order to remove a statue of a wartime comfort woman. The order had been issued on the 7th of October. This decision is not compatible with our position.
very regrettable, and it is not compatible with the steps that have been taken. We will continue to explain the government's position, and we will approach different stakeholders so that we will continue to ask for removal of the statue as quickly as possible. With that, I would like to bring this conference to a close. Thank you.